Sawasdee ka. Welcome to Hot Thai Kitchen. Today's recipe is another one of my childhood faves. It's something called gai pat king. Gai means chicken, pat means to stir fry, and king is ginger. If you've been following the show, you probably noticed that ginger doesn't actually show up too much in Thai cuisine, but this is one of the few dishes where it really is the star of the show. It's super easy, it's kid friendly, or can be made kid friendly, and I'll show you all the techniques. And most importantly, so delicious. Let's get started. Let's look first at our gai, or our chicken. So I'm using chicken thighs because you know I like my thighs, but you can definitely do breasts if you want. Just cut into bite-sized pieces, not too thin because you want to make sure it's nice and juicy. Just gonna marinate this with a little bit of soy sauce. Give that a stir. And you can just do this before you start prepping. It doesn't really need that much time. That's done. Now the sauce, the heart of the stir fry. I've got some oyster sauce right here, and then I'm gonna add some more soy sauce. And this next one is really key to this recipe. I'm adding tau jiao. So tau jiao is basically a fermented soybean paste. It is basically a Thai miso. If you don't have it, you can use sort of miso mixed with some water, or you can use that Korean version of miso as well. I forget what it's called, but the Thai one, this is what it looks like. Ta-da! The label doesn't always look like that, but you know, if it comes in this sort of bottle, healthy boy brand, looks kind of like this, it's probably the right one. A little extra aroma, I'm gonna add some toasted sesame oil. So already, if you've done a lot of Thai stir fries, you notice that things are a little bit different because this is sort of like a Chinese style. Like this has its roots in Chinese cuisine. That's why the sesame oil, that's why the ginger, okay? So a lot of salty stuff has gone in. So I'm just gonna do a touch of sugar to balance out all the saltiness. And I'm gonna add some water just to thin it out, help the sugar dissolve. If you have chicken stock, use chicken stock. But I'm out of chicken stock. Scandalous, but yes, it happens sometimes. So there you go, give that a stir. If you want a little bit of heat, I like to add some white pepper. It's still gonna be kid friendly. Maybe don't add as much as I did if you're making it for kids, but just a touch of it will be a little bit of subtle heat. And as an option, if you want the color to be a little darker, look a little more scrumptious, you can add black soy sauce, or you can also add dark soy sauce. Just be careful with dark soy sauce. It can be a little saltier, but the Thai black soy sauce is not very salty, so you can add a little bit more. So that's the sauce. Let's look at the vegetables real quick before we get cooking. So I've got just three different types of veggies here. Some bell pepper for color. You can do carrots if you want, but I do prefer bell pepper. Some onions and some cloud ear mushroom, also known as wood ear mushroom, also known as black fungus, which I find is usually the label on the packaging. I know it doesn't sound appetizing, but trust me, it's good. It doesn't have much of a flavor at all, but it does have a crunch to it. So I buy mine dry, which looks like this. So this is what they look like dry. Sometimes they'll come already shredded. So all you do is you soak these in hot water, and I just typically do at least 15 minutes, and you'll see that it's bloomed a lot and it looks huge, like four times the size of these guys, okay? If you don't have it, you can use any other kinds of mushrooms that you prefer. And finally, the ginger, lots of ginger, finely julienned. If this amount of ginger terrifies you, don't worry about it, you'll be fine. That's it, let's get cooking. Okay, and you can get your rice ready because this is gonna go fast. So just a little bit of oil in there. I'm gonna add some chopped garlic and also a couple of Thai chilies. It's totally optional. If you're doing this for kids, obviously skip the chilies. If you like the flavor of ginger, but you don't like the spiciness of ginger, add your ginger now. If you saute the ginger in oil, it kind of reduces, it tones down that heat a little bit. But if you, like me, like the heat, the spiciness of ginger, save them for later, okay, when I add them. So if you're making for kids, I would suggest you add the ginger right now. So now that the garlic is starting to turn a little bit golden, I'm gonna go in with my chicken. Give that a quick toss. And now at this point, you want to be at about 30% cooked for the chicken before you add your other things. So right about now looks good. The other things being the sauce, the ginger. Yes, I know, it's a lot of ginger. That's excellent. And all of your vegetables. I know, this is such an easy recipe. Everything goes in almost at the same time. And now all we have to do is toss this around until the chicken is fully cooked. And you're done. How easy is that? And if you want, at this point, you want the color a little darker, feel free to just add a couple of drops of black soy sauce. Depending on the brand, some brands are really, really dark. So like half a teaspoon and it's like, whoa. So, you know, don't go crazy. The beauty of this dish, I find, is if you add the chicken and the vegetables sort of at this timing, it just kind of all ends up perfectly cooked at the same time. All right, that looks perfect and beautiful. Now I'm going to add some greenery with some green onions. Give it one quick toss and off heat. We're done. The smell is so nostalgic to me. And yes, this is the kind of stir fry where you want a lot of sauce, a lot of liquid, because that's the best part. You sort of like pour the sauce all over your rice. So you definitely don't want this to be dry at the end. Ooh, look at that. Yeah, when I was little, all I wanted was the chicken and nothing else. But now I want a little bit of everything. Oh, yes. Let me get some of that sauce. What a unique flavor. It looks like a really simple stir fry, but that unique combination of tau tiao and the ginger really creates something that is unlike any other Thai stir fry. Again, I made mine a little spicy with the ginger being added later and the white pepper and the Thai chili. If you're making this for kids, like when we were little, we didn't add the Thai chili definitely, and light on the white pepper. And as I said, ginger in the beginning. And it's just an easy, fantastic, delicious dish. Like, I can't describe how good this is to you. You've got to try it for yourself. So the recipe, as always, will be on hotthaikitchen.com. When you make it, send me a photo on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. And if you haven't subscribed to the show, make sure you do so you don't miss a delicious recipe like this. And click the little bell icon as well so you'll get a notification when I post a new video. And if you love the show and you want to support us, please check out our Patreon link in the description box below. And I will see you next time for your next delicious Thai meal. Hello, hello, hello! Okay.